गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास 9th सब्जेक्ट साइंस चैप्टर 8 मोशन. इट्स योर लेक्चर नंबर 1. टॉपिक्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड इन टूडेज लेक्चर आर व्हाट इज मोशन, व्हाट इज रेस्ट, टाइप्स ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज, डिस्टेंस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन डिस्टेंस एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट, व्हाट इज यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड व्हाट इज नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. Now, in everyday life, we see some objects at rest and others in motion. Birds fly, fish swim, blood flows through the arteries and veins, cars move, atoms, molecules, planets, stars and galaxies, they all are in motion. Now, how to define motion or what is motion? An object, it may appear to be moving for one person and it may be stationary for some other person. How? Let us take an example. Here, it is person number 1, 2 and 3. 1 and 2, they are sitting or standing in a bus. The bus is moving in this direction. So, for person 1, this third, it is in motion. For person 2, this third person who is standing outside on the road, it is in motion. For person 3, person 1 and person 2, both are in motion because bus is in motion. Now, for person 1, 2 is at rest and for person 2, 1 is at rest. Therefore, motion is a relative thing. It depends upon the reference point also. So, how to define motion? Motion. If an object changes its position with respect to time and with respect to surroundings, or we can say reference point, it is said to be motion. I repeat, when an object changes its position with respect to time as well as with respect to reference point, that object is said to be motion. Now, when the object is said to be rest? An object is said to be at rest when it does not change its position with respect to time and with respect to reference point. It is said to be at rest. Means there is no change in position of that object with respect to reference point and with respect to time. So, are you clear about motion and rest? So, we can say that motion and rest both are relative terms. They both are relative terms. Now, coming to next topic. What is a physical quantity? What do you understand by physical quantity? Physical quantity, it is a name given to a property, characteristics or phenomenon in our nature which can be measured. For example, there are two boxes A and B. Now, if I say that A box, it is heavier than B box. So, what is that physical quantity? Yes, tell me, what is that physical quantity? You know the answer? Yes, that is mass. So, we say that A object or A box, it has greater mass as compared to B object or B box. So, mass was an example of physical quantity. So, are you clear about physical quantity? It can be measured. Now, what are the types of physical quantities? What are the types? Basically, there are two types of physical quantity, scalar quantity and vector quantity. What are its two types? Scalar and vector. Now, what are these two quantities? Scalar quantity is that quantity which has magnitude only. It has only and only magnitude. That is called a scalar quantity. For example, mass, length, they both have magnitude only. Now, what is a vector quantity? Vector quantity is that quantity which has magnitude, direction, plus it also follows vector laws of addition. So these three things, they must be satisfied. These three conditions must be satisfied for a vector quantity. Example, force, velocity, they are vector quantity. So are you clear about scalar quantity and vector quantity? Okay. Now coming to next topic, distance and displacement. What do you understand by the term distance and displacement? Let us consider an example. There are two points A and B. I have considered two point A and point B. Now an object is traveling from point A to point B through different paths. Either through this first path, either through this second path, or this third path, or it might be taking this fourth path. So these are the different paths followed by an object in moving from point A to point B. So what can you infer from this diagram? That there are different paths followed by that object in moving from point A to point B. Now the actual path length covered by the object in moving from point A to point B, that actual path length, that is called as distance. That is called as distance. And the shortest distance, the shortest distance in moving from point A to point B, means from its initial position to its final position, that shortest distance, that is called as displacement. I repeat, the actual path covered by that object, that is distance. And the shortest distance between the initial position and final position, that is called as displacement. So first path, second path and fourth path, they are distance. Whereas this third path, we can say it is displacement. So how to define distance now? It is the actual path length covered by a moving body during a given time. That is called as distance. And what is SI unit of distance? It is meter. And we represent meter by small m. Okay. Now what is the quantity of distance? Scalar quantity or vector quantity? It is scalar quantity because it has magnitude only. Remember that distance, it has magnitude only. The direction is not specified. That is why it is a scalar quantity. Now distance, it has only positive value. It cannot have zero value or negative value. Now displacement, it is the shortest distance traveled by an object from its initial position to its final position. That is called as displacement. And what is the SI unit of displacement? That is meter, represented by m, same as of distance. And which quantity, scalar or vector? It is a vector quantity because it has direction, it has magnitude also. That is why it is a vector quantity. Now displacement, it can have a zero value when the initial and final position are same. That has zero value. It can have negative value also. It can have a positive value also. So this is about distance and displacement. Now if motion is in a straight line, if motion is in a straight line, distance is equal to displacement. And if motion is not in a straight line, distance is always greater than displacement. You can see from the diagram also, it is in a straight line, motion is in straight line, so distance is equal to displacement. And motion is not in a straight line, in this case and in this case, distance is always greater than displacement. So what can you infer from these two equations? Distance is always equal to or greater than displacement. This is a very important point. Please note down. Distance is always equal to or greater than displacement. Now, some students might have confusion about the SI unit. What is SI unit? Why we are not taking distance in centimeter? So, I have a reason. Please see. There are three units, three systems we can say. CGS, MKS, FPS. CGS stands for centimeter, G for gram, S for seconds, M stands for M meter, K for kilogram, S for second, F stands for foot, P stands for pound, S stands for second. So these are the three systems. Now this MKS system, that is considered the SI unit system. That's why we say the SI unit of distance is meter. That is SI unit. It can be centimeter, no doubt. But I am talking about only SI unit. We should always take the any data in SI unit. So the SI unit is in meter for distance and displacement. So MKS unit, it is considered as SI unit. So are you clear about the distance, displacement, physical quantities, scalar quantity, vector quantity, and what is SI unit basically? Now moving on. So what is the difference between distance and displacement? Distance is the total path length covered by an object during a given time. Displacement is the shortest distance traveled by an object from its initial position to final position. Distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. Distance is always positive. Displacement, it can be negative or positive. Distance is greater than or equal to displacement. Displacement is less than or equal to distance. So are you clear about the differences between distance and displacement? Okay. Now you know about motion. Now what is when the object is said to be motion, when the object is said to be rest. Now motion is classified into two categories, uniform motion and non-uniform motion. And this non-uniform motion, it is further classified into uniformly accelerated motion, non-uniformly accelerated motion. Now we will study each type in detail. So first case is uniform motion. What is uniform motion? What do you understand by this term? If a body travels equal distance in each and every equal interval of time, that is said to be uniform motion. Equal distance in each and every equal interval of time. And if a body travels unequal distance in each and every equal interval of time, that is non-uniform motion. Now you can take the example of uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Suppose you consider an object moving along a straight line. You consider an object which is moving along this straight line. Now let it travel 5 meter in 1 second, 5 meter in first second, 5 meter more in the next second, and 5 meter more in the next second. Means in each and every time, in each and every 1 second, it is traveling 5 meter. So 5 meter in 1 second, next 5 meter in 1 second, next 5 meter in 1 second. Means equal distance is traveled in each and every equal interval of time. So that is uniform motion. That is uniform motion. Now what are the examples of non-uniform motion? Non-uniform motion, what are the examples? For example, when a car, it is moving on a crowded street, or a person is jogging in the park. A person is jogging in the park, that is non-uniform motion, because unequal distance in each and every equal interval of time. And when the car is moving on a crowded street, in that case also, that is a non-uniform motion. So are you clear about uniform and non-uniform motion? In uniform, equal distance in each and every equal interval of time, and in non-uniform, unequal distance in each and every equal interval of time. So this was about uniform and non-uniform motion. So this ends for today's lecture. What is your homework? Differentiate between distance and displacement. That is your first question. Second question, an object has moved through a distance. Can it have zero displacement? If yes, Support your answer with an example. Question number third. A farmer moves along the boundary of a square field of side 10 meter in 40 seconds. What will be the magnitude of displacement of the farmer at the end of 2 minute 20 second from its initial position? Question number fourth. Which of the following is true for displacement? A. It cannot be zero. B. Its magnitude is greater than the distance traveled by the object. You will have to choose between these two. Now the last question, fifth. An athlete completes one round of a circular track of diameter 200 meter in 40 seconds. In 40 seconds. What will be the distance covered and displacement at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds? So these are the 5 questions you will have to do in your notebook today. So this ends for today's lecture. Thank you, students.